Good morning, everyone. Thank you for starting the day out with me. I'm Jenna Stauffer. Now, cruise ships and their impact on Key West, both positive and negative, have long divided the community. One of the biggest issues that the residents of Key West are facing, of course, is the dredging referendum on October 1st. Now, here on Good Morning Florida Keys, we'll talk with both sides of this issue, those who are for it and those who oppose it. This morning, I'm going to talk with Jolly Benson. He is the chairman of the Key West Committee for Responsible Tourism. Jolly, thank you for being here with me today.
Thank you so much for having me. It's a pleasure.
All right, Jolly. Obviously, this is something that is so important to you. You've decided to become the chairman of the Key West Council for Responsible Tourism. Jolly, why are you so passionate about this issue?
Well, I've never been involved in anything political before in my life, and I voted, obviously, but this was an issue that I felt was far too important to just let it be decided as it was. So when they were proposing to dredge the Cut B, which is the main shipping channel, which they're still trying to dredge, this was before talk of it's just a study, not a decision. They were actually trying to say, if we don't dredge this, certain cruise ship companies won't be able to call on us. And we felt that that was just so short-sighted and using all of our resources for the gain of just a few people, that it was time to stand up. I was talking to people around the community, and everybody seemed to agree that we needed a voice, and I just happened to be around, and I've read enough studies, and I've read 12 books on it, and I just happened to be pretty well informed, and they decided that it should be something that I could take on as chairman of the political action committee that we started.
Okay, great. So that's how responsible tourism really got started. And now tell me kind of, I mean, you're telling me everything that you're against, you know, obviously what you stand for. What are your main goals by forming this group though, Jolly?
Our main goal through October 1st is going to be ensure a no vote on October 1st. That would eliminate any chance of what they're calling a study, which is actually the next phase in dredging the harbor. And after that, we're going to start looking at ways to, as our name says, become more responsible with our tourism. We understand that tourism is our industry here. It's going to be our lifeblood for quite some time. And we need to figure out ways to bring in people that are coming down for our culture, for our architecture, for our arts, for our natural environment, rather than just coming here because it's a stop on an itinerary for 6 hours. And there's nothing against cruise ships. We understand that they're a vital part of our economy. We don't feel that we need to destroy one of our greatest assets in the National Marine Sanctuary to accommodate a few cruise ship lines.
Now, Jolly, I've checked out your opponents, kind of their view on everything.
Sure.
And they say, Jolly, that the study, it's just a study. It's okay. Not the final decision. So what do you say back to that?
I would say let's look back at what the Army Corps of Engineers has done in the past. So in 2010, the city asked them to do a reconnaissance study. They did one, and it came out relatively favorably for dredging the harbor. Now, the Army Corps of Engineers is not taking into account anything that impacts us locally or regionally. They only consider the national impacts of this project. So they said, based on their findings, that nationally this would make sense, although it would be illegal to dredge inside the National Marine Sanctuary. Their summary actually says it's illegal to study further, which our proponents, the proponents of this study, are saying isn't the case. We'll see about that. Now, when the Army Corps of Engineers does a feasibility study, they are looking at how to go about doing the project. In this case, how to go about dredging in the National Marine Sanctuary, not whether if it's a good idea to do it or not. They've already done that with their reconnaissance study. So this is the second step to implementing the actual project itself. They're not trying to say, is this still a good idea? They think that it is a good idea, and if we bring it back to them as a non-congressional sponsor, that means that we also agree that the reconnaissance study findings are something that we want to pursue. Now, once the feasibility study is completed, the chief's report, the person who's in charge of the Army Corps study, sends that directly to Congress. That does not come back to Key West for another second vote. We don't get to decide on the findings of this study. Once we ask them to do a feasibility study, it's indicated that we're interested in pursuing the project through the end.
Okay.
So that's why we'd like to make sure that we get this nipped in the bud now, that we get a no vote on October 1st. The city of Key West and its citizens have had enough of this sort of thing. It's been brought up every 5 years, give or take, for the last 20. And it's always been defeated, but it always keeps coming back. And we want to make sure that now the people's voice is understood, that we don't really want to rip up our National Marine Sanctuary to benefit a few people.
Great. And Jolly, I guess I can just ask you, I mean, you kind of explained it, but what would you say you'd be most scared of if this were to happen to Key West?
Well, firstly, we have the environmental impact. We're going to be ripping up Nautical Mile, which is a little over a mile long, 150 feet wide. Just to put a visual on that, if you take Duval Street from end to end and you pile up all the rubble and all the sponges and all the corals and live bottom that they want to take out of the National Marine Sanctuary, it would go from Duval Street end to end, curb to curb, 15 feet tall. That's 150,000 cubic yards of fill. And we don't know where that's going to go. It's obviously not going on Duval Street. But it's a whole lot of material. So the environmental impact is significant. Now they're going to say things like, well, there's mitigation, which means they take this healthy healthy coral colonies and they try to transplant it somewhere else. But they're trying to transplant it where there isn't already coral. So we have no guarantees that it will grow there. We do know that it's growing where it's growing and it's rather healthy. And right inside the National Marine Sanctuary, which has never been done before. The Army Corps of Engineers has never dredged in a National Marine Sanctuary. So the environmental impact is significant. Economically, we're putting at risk, we're taking an industry that gives us roughly 7% of our overall contribution to the economy. That's the cruise ship industry. That includes the disembarkation fees, money spent on the island, sales tax, all that stuff. And we're putting that up against 93% of our economy, which is hotels, restaurants, everything such as, you know, these industries that contribute well over $750 million to us annually. So people that are in hotels and staying here don't want to go downtown when we're overcrowded with tourism, when we're overcrowded with cruise ships. Now, we understand that cruise ships are going to be here. We're fine with that. We just don't think that we should be ripping up our National Marine Sanctuary to bring in bigger cruise ships.
Great. Now, Jolly, if people share your same opinion, your same beliefs, can they get involved with responsible tourism?
Of course. You can go to the website. It's www.responsibletourismkw.com. There's a site there that has all these studies that I've referenced. A lot of dull reading, but it's worth it. And then we also have a Facebook page that you can find right there on the website. You can contribute, but really we need people to just talk and be informed and tell their neighbors what's going on and what is at stake here, that it's not just a study that we get to gather more information about. This is the decision to go forward with this project.
Great. Jolly, thank you so much for being on this morning. And again, we'll have both sides of this issue on Good Morning Florida Keys. I'm going to take a quick break right now, but I'll be right back after these messages. Stay with me. There's much more to come.